Hi there. Thanks for coming back to our Hope and Heals channel on YouTube. Jay Soul signing in. I wanted to welcome you and welcome in the holiday season. It is Christmas time. Officially, we're in December and we've gotten started at our first week of December. And I wanted to just come in and share some thoughts about the holiday season, the Christmas season. Jesus is the reason for the season. I'm wearing a Christmas shirt. It says the Mama Elf. This was a shirt that we used in our Christmas greeting card last year. Me and the boys, they are the brother elves because I have two boys. And we took a picture in the Christmas tree. So we have started our decorating and, you know, are looking forward to the holiday and celebrating. We've got a big month coming up this month. Lots to be thankful for, which with Thanksgiving was great. But I do want to share that I know that the holidays for a lot of people come, certain words or certain feelings come up with the holidays. And I don't think anyone is immune to some of those feelings that are hard during these times, this time of the year. So those feelings, they include feelings like depression, feelings of grief, if we've lost loved ones. And I know many of us in the last couple of years have lost a number of loved ones. Another thing that comes up is loneliness. A feeling of loneliness is something that people struggle with during the holidays, and it's a difficult time for a lot of people. And then also what happens for a lot of people, and happened recently to me, is sickness. I was sick last week. I was off. I was on vacation, and it seemed like it just hit me. But it was like kind of hit or miss. You know, one day I was okay, then the next day I was, you know, flat on my face and in bed the whole day and just medicating and just didn't know what was happening, what was going on, why I was, you know, feeling so horrible. But it was on and off throughout the whole week. When I got to Friday, I realized, okay, Monday I'm supposed to be back at work and I'm not better. I don't feel better and I need to maybe step up my game in my self-care. And during that time, you know, my phone was very quiet. I did have help from my family who came through for me when I really needed it, bringing me soup, helping to take care of my son that's here at home with me, taking him so that he wasn't just stuck here in the sick house with mom. And that was really great. But still, I still had a lot of feelings of loneliness, and it was difficult being alone and being able to deal with feeling so horrible and just wanting to be better. The week didn't go anything like I had planned at all. But I'm sure that there's a reason and there's things that I learned during that time. And I'm a lot better now, thank goodness. And of course, you know, I started being concerned that maybe the illness was more than I thought. I thought it was just a cold cough, you know, that was brought on by allergies. But I thought, you know, I better be sure. I better make sure. And a couple of family members did recommend that I should check and see. Maybe it's COVID. It was not. Thank you, Jesus. It was not. But I did need to make sure. And so for the first time, I had that test taken and got the negative result, which is, you know, what I was hoping for, of course. But anyway, it was a week that I learned a lot, and I really, really had to exercise my faith muscle in doing that. And then this week, going back to work, I heard a song, and it just really spoke to me about Jesus and what Jesus is and has been for me. For many years now, and most, you know, really started getting even more so in the last 8 years. And so, and for me, that's hope. I find my hope in the Lord. I heard this song and it just made me want to share. It is a Christmas song, but it's a new one that is that's being played on the radio. It's by Matthew West and it's called The Hope of Christmas. And what better song that a Hope and Heals channel to endorse than a song that has the word hope in it. So I want to share that song with you, and then I do have some scripture, a couple of scriptures that really speak to me, and hope hacks that I'd like to share as well. If anybody is having those feelings that I mentioned before, grief, loneliness, sickness, depression, this is a difficult time of year, and those things rear their ugly heads at in our lives. I certainly am not immune to having those feelings and having to deal with them. So the song has a line in it that the world looks dark. It doesn't say the world is dark. It says the world looks dark. And I know I've had my moments where the world looked very dark, but knowing the love of Jesus and having that comfort, when I lay down in bed at night, I think of Jesus and I thank Jesus and I praise Jesus, and because I know that He's there with me. I'm alone in my bed. Nobody's there with me, but I know that He is, and I thank Him for giving me strength, for giving me comfort, for giving me love, and for giving me hope. Knowing that I'm going through struggles and I'm having challenges, but they are all for my good. They are all to make me better. So I want to go ahead and begin the song and share that with you. And I hope that you enjoy the song. I'm going to do my best to sing it well. Matthew West, The Hope of Christmas. Take me back to 8 years old, a little church on a dead end road, with a candle flicker in one hand and Dad's hand in the other. Take me back to silent night, my heart was full and the world was right, 'cause right now the world looks nothing like those innocent Decembers. These days peace on earth is hard to find, and I need you to remind me one more time. You're still the hope of Christmas. You're still the light when the world looks dark. You're still the hope of Christmas. And you're still the hope of my heart. Watch the snowflakes falling down like a blanket on this town. For a moment we can hardly see the pain this year has brought us. May the sick find healing's touch, may hatred's fight be won with love, and may every heart make room for you, the one who came to save us. You're still the hope of Christmas. You're still the light when the world looks dark. You're still the hope of Christmas. And you're still the hope of my heart. Bowed my head to pray tonight, felt my boy by my side. He slipped his hand in mine, and we both talked to you. And it took me back to 8 years old, my daddy's hand in a story told about heaven's love in a manger low, and a parade must that's still true. You're still the hope of Christmas. You're still the light when the world looks dark. You're still the hope of Christmas. And you're still the hope of my heart. You're still the hope of Christmas. You're still the light when the world looks dark. You're still the I hope that you enjoyed that rendition. Made it a little bit different, put my own little flavor, J-Soul flavor on it. But I do want to share the scriptures that come to mind and the hope packs that I have. So I have my trusty Hope and Heals journal. And the first scripture that I thought of is 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10, which says, "And the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast." And then the other scripture that I really, really love, and I've loved for so long, and I truly believe in, is Jeremiah 29:11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." So my hope hacks that come from these scriptures is to find the blessing in my circumstance. It talks about in Peter 5:10, 1 Peter 5:10, how we're gonna suffer a little while, but Jesus himself, God himself, is going to restore us and make us strong, firm, and steadfast. That brings me a lot of hope for my future. That yes, I'm gonna go through struggles. I'm gonna have times that are difficult. Those times are the times when I need to go to him most and believe in him most and have hope in him most. And that's what I'm learning in these struggles. What I think about when I try to find the blessing in my circumstance is, number one, don't focus on what has left me or my life. Not to be focused on the things that I feel like I have lost. And I know that a lot of us have that feeling that we've lost a lot of things, a lot, or people. Instead, what I decide to do is focus on what is left with me and in my life, and to find that gratitude for those blessings, for those things, for the grace that I still am receiving every day. Also, to make the choice to rejoice. And rejoicing is to delight in God's grace. Again, graces and blessings that we receive on a daily basis. Even things, when things don't work out to plan, a lot of times those are blessings in disguise. I choose to view it as God keeping me from something or keeping me for something when my plans do not work out the way that I was hoping that they would. A change in plan is not always a bad thing. And I usually always try to look for the silver lining behind anything that happens. Again, we all have struggles, we all have challenges to deal with, and it's the way that we decide to manage those things and to remember, like we keep letting you know and keep reminding you, that we don't have to do life alone. Jesus is always with us. You've got our Hope and Heal squad here to pray for you as well. But I just want to encourage you, hope that this song leads you to remember having hope in Jesus and having hope in his power and authority to restore you, to restore your life, to restore everything that you feel maybe is gone. You're going to have even better. You're going to get even better. And I believe that for myself as well. So that is my sharing for this week. I'm wishing you a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. Be well and be safe. Have fun. I'm going to be doing those things as well. And so at this point, J-Soul signing off for Hope and Heals.